Let us do another problem to see if we fully understand this. It says the temperature of 2.00 moles of an ideal monatomic gas. We read the problem, so we go. N equals, what are our whole processes as we read this? The temperature of 2.00 moles of an ideal monatomic gas. So N equals 2.00 mole. My first thought, three significant digit problem. I need to give my answers as three significant digits. Of an ideal monatomic gas. It's ideal, it's monatomic. So immediately know that C, molar specific heat of constant volume is going to equal 3 over 2 R. I hope in previous videos I never wrote 2 over 3. There's no 2 over 3, it's 3 over 2. Even kinetic energy is 3 over 2 KT, Boltzmann's constant times temperature. So as I read this, I've seen this 2.00 mol, first thought, three significant digits. It is ideal monatomic gas, so immediately I'm thinking Cv equals 3 over 2. And its temperature is raised by 15 Kelvin, so delta T equals 15.0 Kelvin, again three significant digits. At constant volume, so this is a constant volume problem, so immediately this was correct there. What are the work done by the gas? What is the work done under constant volume? It is zero. Because remember my integral for work, I always forget to put the music off. So it's going from some volume initial to some volume final of PdV. But here there's no change in volume, so this equals that. So my integral is this zero, there's no work done. Next question. The energy transferred as heat. Heat equals NCV delta T. We were given N, this is monatomic, ideal, constant volume, so I can replace that with N 3 over 2 R delta T. And see how beautiful this works out, because next question is the change in internal energy. First law of thermodynamics. Wait, that was bad. Change in internal energy equals Q minus W. But because work was zero, this equation and this equation is going to be the change in internal energy and Q are going to be exactly the same, in as much as W is zero in this case. And lastly, what is the change in kinetic energy per atom? The average kinetic energy per atom equals 3 over 2 K delta T, if this becomes delta K average. So a nice problem, and we start thinking about stuff as we read the problem. In this video I just want to have a quick look at the equipartition of energy, a concept by James Maxwell, and he wanted to see why the molar specific heat of constant volume, or the pressure, is not the same for monatomic, diatomic and polyatomic. And this degrees of freedom, or the equipartition of energy, he said that all the energy in a gas can be only in certain forms, and they would come in, I don't want to call it packets, but stay in units of a half times the Boltzmann's constant times the temperature. And if you look at a monatomic gas, and you look at what motion those atoms can have. Well, first they can move in a three-dimensional space. So they can move in the I roof, J roof, K roof direction. So that will give them 3 degrees of freedom. So this will be 3, and that is where we get the 3 over 2 KT for each atom's kinetic energy. Now let's look at a diatomic molecule. So I have 1, 2 parts to it. So they can still move in that direction, translational, up, down, left, right, front and back. But they can also rotate along each other. I think the textbook explains that they can move as a spring, but let's just look at their rotation. So if I put this down, they have two, they can rotate this way around each other and this way around each other, but this doesn't count. This is not rotation. There's no change. I can rotate it in any way by any amount of radians or degrees. You won't notice a difference. Certainly there's a symmetry along this axis of rotation. So there's actually only They can rotate this way, or they can rotate this way, so that way or this way. But this rotation, so there'll only be another 2 half kt's. So this is going to equal 3/2 kt, and this is going to equal 1 kt or 2/2, so 2/2 kt. And if you add those together, you're going to get 5/2 kt. And that's where we get the 5/2 for diatomic gases. But if we now suddenly have 3 polyatomic or more, they will have 3 axes of rotational movement as well. So here we were going to get another 3/2. And 3/2 plus 3/2, that's 6/2, and so that's going to equal 3 kt for their average kinetic, kinetic energy. The last concept for this chapter is just to look at the 2 forms of adiabatic processes. Remember, right in the beginning we said an adiabatic process, 2 types. Either it occurs so quickly, if you think of a sound wave, I say hello, this is compressing and expansion of air as the wave moves. It happens so quickly that there can't be transfer really of internal energy, of heat actually I should say. There's no time for transfer of heat because the process happens so quickly. So Q, for adiabatic process, Q equals 0. There was another form of adiabatic process, and that was just the free expansion. Free expansion. So, and those two have quite different expansion, quite different equations. So this is an adiabatic process for which Q equals 0. These are isotherms, from some initial to some final state. So there's a change in temperature, and so definitely there's going to be a change in internal, there's going to be an change in internal energy. But not as Q, only as work. And since we have a different volume, volume initial, volume final, there's a change, so there is going to be work. So the only change in internal energy is going to come from work. And there is a temperature difference for this first adiabatic process. That it happens too quickly, or it's so well insulated that there's no change in energy. And what was noted was that P, pressure, times the volume to the power gamma is a constant. And what is that gamma? Well, gamma equals Cp divided by Cv, molar specific heat under constant pressure divided by molar specific heat at constant volume. So that is a constant. Now, this line is called an adiabat. While this was an isotherm, this line is called an adiabat. And if I just get P on its own on this side, it's going to equal some constant divided by V to the power and gamma. And since the gas goes from some initial state, so just looking at running through all the equations quickly, since it goes from some initial state to some final state and they're both equal to constants, remember that V initial to the power gamma is going to equal P initial, V final, also to the power gamma. If I take this to be an ideal gas, where PV equals nRT, and I just replace P, P equals nRT divided by V. If I replace that in there, we're also going to see that nRT over V, and then V to the power gamma is also going to be a constant. Since N is going to be a constant, if I go from some initial to some final state, N is a constant, C is a constant, I actually get that T, V, so that's going to be gamma minus 1. So I'm just bringing this up. It's going to equal N times R times a constant, which still remains the same constant. And then finally, if I go from some initial to final state, temperature initial, V initial gamma minus 1 is going to equal temperature final times volume going final to the power of gamma minus 1. So those are the important, let's try and highlight them, just the important equations. This one, constant, we're only looking at this now. This one, and then finally this one. Now let's quickly consider free expansion. During free expansion, there's going to be no change in temperature. Just remember that. Free expansion equals temperature equals constant. So if temperature initial and temperature final, if temperature initial and temperature final are the same, remember that we again we are just stuck with the P initial, V initial equals P final, V final. So these are both adiabatic processes, but all of this is only going to do where there's such a good insulation or the process happens so fast. It's not free expansion as an example of adiabatic process. In free expansion, we're just talking normal ideal gas, in as much as this would have been over T initial, over T final, but T initial equals T final. So that's where we are left. Let's just make sure I haven't forgotten anything. Yeah. So when it's free expansion, please don't use these equations. Just back to the ideal gas laws for some initial to some final state in free expansion.